I think the society was really paralyzed at that time. And everyone was looking at the mortality figures and trying to think about, you know, what can we do? How can we help out?
When something like this happens, actions have to be taken immediately. Time is extremely important.
Here we are in the beginning of March with Europe completely shutting down. SAS had to take the decision that 90% of all staff were to be furloughed. I had a call with Karin Nyman, head of communication at SAS, and this idea came about to try to reskill cabin crew to work into the healthcare sector. What I did was to call Fredrik Hillesson, and we decided then and there to make our utmost into actually try to make this happen. I think it was successful because you had such great motivation to pitch in and to help out. I mean, think of this as a movie scene where you have a cabin crew member serving champagne on a flight from Hong Kong on the Saturday, on Sunday getting the notice that you are furloughed, and on a Monday you answer yes to an email that comes asking you if you were willing to reskill and enter straight into the COVID-19 healthcare sector to help out. And I think these people are the true heroes of this story. Without the support and the network of Jacob, Husky and Poker, this would not have been possible.
Initially, it was extremely hectic and things had to be set up from scratch. And there were a few people who took a lot of initiatives into getting these different labs up and running. Lars Engstrand and other people, they managed to get equipment shipped from China. There were also many researchers and students who helped out. And now it's all up and running, and I think they have done 200,000 tests. I think that the key factor in the success of the Wallenberg investment here was time, that they acted quickly. It was absolutely crucial to get the tests and the samples done immediately.
But what happens now? Can we really create that type of collaboration and sense of urgency that is needed for the massive reskilling that we need in society? I don't want to put a question mark, but I think we really need to work hard on making that happen, even though we're not in the middle of the crisis.
So for the future, we need to think about setting up a pandemic center so that we are prepared and have all the available robotics, methods, people in place and ready to act on short notice.